We are whirling through space, drifting toward eternity. Mystical sparks encircled by loneliness and cold darkness. Are you afraid? So are a lot of other people. One of the reasons witchcraft has survived through the ages is because man's need to coerce destiny and subdue the fear within has never subsided. Witchcraft attempts to deceive, cajole, and otherwise disturb natural inclination and occurrences. Witches know about the universal energy of which all things are part. You, the stars, the trees, the rocks, the gods. We know how to tune into this energy and use it. A witch is a psychic female who, with magical secrets and sheer force of will, makes things happen. I'm a witch. My mother is a witch. My grandmother is a witch, and my grandmother's great-grandmother was a witch. I'm a sixth-generation witch. With magic, I control energy. With magic, I can help you become a power. With enchantment, spells, and charms, you will soon be able to rearrange the law and order of all things. Long ago, herbs and fire were used to influence the gods. The pungent aromas were meant to stimulate the senses of the deity. And when the deity was aroused, the deity was compassionate. If you would like special favors from the gods, honor them. The gods will protect their own. I know a god who controls all physical power. With his help, you will be able to generate the impulses needed to attract a multitude of lovers. His name is Jupiter. He is the god of creativity. Raw creativity. If you acknowledge him by lighting candles in his name, he will reward you with great seductive energy. Your love affairs will be brilliant, vibrant, bold.